the Georgia Dome, the 14th-ranked Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech against the 24th-ranked Commodores of Vanderbilt, a renewal of a very old rivalry, but their first meeting in 3 years. Hi, and welcome, everyone. I'm Chris Fowler. This is a quadruple header of basketball on ESPN. Vandy and Georgia Tech next. Vandy just coming off a win over another ACC team in Wake Forest. After the Commodores and the Jackets are done, two unbeaten teams as LSU visits the Brothers O'Bannon and UCLA in Pauley Pavilion. After SportsCenter at midnight Eastern time, a rematch of that great upset in the NCAA tournament as Santa Clara, coming off two victories over Pac-10 teams on the road, takes on Arizona. Will it be payback time for the Wildcats? At halftime tonight, we'll have scores and highlights. Arkansas and Purdue in action tonight, among other teams. But right after this, it's off to the Georgia Dome. Georgia Tech never lost in the Kuppenheimer Classic, and their excellent guard, Travis Best, taking on Vanderbilt. Joy.
Ready. You want to buy brand name golf equipment for up to 30% off? Then come to Pro Golf's giant Christmas sale.
That's right. You can buy name brand golf clubs, bags, shoes, and clothing for men and women during Pro Golf's giant Christmas sale for up to 30% off. That's up to 30% off.
And remember, only Pro Golf guarantees the best price on the same golf equipment or it's free. That's why Pro Golf is America's favorite gift store.
Let Lady Luck Casino stuff your Christmas stocking with holiday cash. It's all part of Lady Luck Casino's 12 Days of Christmas $40,000 cash giveaway. Each of the 12 days before Christmas, Lady Luck Casino is giving away thousands of dollars in cash to lucky winners. Plus, tickets to the 1993 Liberty Bowl. Register for all of the drawings. But don't miss the big one on Christmas Eve for $12,000 and four tickets to the Liberty Bowl. It's Lady Luck Casino's 12 Days of Christmas $40,000 cash giveaway.
We're back at the Georgia Dome. We get set for our second ball game of the evening. It pits Georgia Tech against the Commodores of Vanderbilt. Welcome back to Atlanta, everybody. Brad Nessler and Larry Connolly. Just a couple guys sitting around, living large. Great seats, huh?
Terrific seats. You know what? This is where I would be sitting at home watching you.
We've got everything we need here. This is Terry, our waitress. Thank
Terry,
you, Terry.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Well, our first game, Kansas survived Georgia. This one might end up being better.
Well, we've got two champions. We've got the ACC champions in Georgia Tech, the SEC champions in Vanderbilt. We've got a great matchup.
Two great tandems in the backcourt, too, for both teams. And Bobby Kremen says his point guard might be the best one he's ever had.
Travis follows the line of some great point guards, Mark Price and Kenny Anderson. And I really feel that Travis defensively is better than both those guys. And he can shoot maybe better than Kenny and almost as Mark Price.
Speaking of an offensive star, as Travis Best is, he's going to have to shut down Billy McCaffrey, who is the leading scorer for this Vanderbilt club. But he's also a great passer and a great leader. Terrific guard matchup, Brad.
Everybody's preseason All-American, Billy McCaffrey. Travis Best, one of the best in the country. We might have one of the best games in the country. Cheers. We'll be back with Georgia Tech and Vanderbilt in a moment.
Affordable gift ideas. Watch for our holiday circular.
Jim was going where no man had ever gone, into the darkest jungles of Malaysia.
Did you find it, Jim?
Yeah.
Thought you could use a cold one.
Great. Ice cold O'Doul's. Not alcohol, and hey, only 70 calories. Just right for a true adventurer like Jim. Jim was going where no man had ever gone.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without the alcohol, think O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
Citibank has really given us a new sense of self because we have our own identities.
I have a Citibank Visa card, and it does have my photo on it, so I have one less worry.
And not only that, but you can pick what you like, so it doesn't look like a DMV photo.
I don't know why the other credit cards aren't doing the same thing.
We need a photo card. The family members can tell us apart. Introducing the first credit card with your photo and signature on front from not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
Do you dream in color? In bottomless blues and screaming yellows? In sounds that shake you to the bottom of your heart? In images clear as crystal and brilliant as ice? In faraway worlds as close as your fingertips? These are what dreams and Sony Trinitron televisions are made of. Make one come true for you. It's your life. Isn't it worth a Sony?
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Sony. It's your life. Isn't it worth a Sony? And by the new Dodge, a division of the Chrysler Corporation.
Back at the Georgia Dome, close to 30,000 on hand for our second matchup of the evening. And let's take a look at our top starting lineup. First, for the Commodores of Vanderbilt. We talked about the point guards for these teams. Wally McMahon, one of the best swing men in the SEC, with McCaffrey, Lawson, Evans, and Hall. For Jan Van Brennekoff, the head coach in his first season at Vandy, and a former SEC Player of the Year at Vandy in his playing days. Three seasons as a Division I head coach. He takes on a Georgia Tech team that features another pretty good off guard, Drew Berry, a sophomore. And with Travis Best, one of the best backcourts in the business. Newville, Forrest, and Moore round out the Georgia Tech lineup for Bobby Cremins in his 13th season in Atlanta. 245 wins here, 345 overall during his career. And he's hoping that James Forrest came to play today, Larry.
Well, this is the tournament MVP in the ACC tournament last year. He was outstanding. 26 points, 69% field goal percentage. He led Tech to that ACC championship last year. Been down a little bit this year. He's had an Achilles tendonitis problem, and has probably playing about 70%. Bobby Cremins a little upset with the way he's been playing, as Martise Moore the same way, who's had a bad finger. So some nagging injuries right now, but there's the man who leads Vanderbilt.
And Billy McCaffrey's been struggling a little bit with his shot. Still, he's their leading scorer. There's the comparison on what he did a year ago. Just brilliant in the three-point shooting. And he is struggling this year, 39% from the field.
He's also a marked man, and that makes such a difference, Brad, because you get a lot of gimmicky defenses thrown at you when you know you've got one big guy out there, and McCaffrey really is the leader of this club.
Our officials tonight, Tim Higgins, Zelton Steed, and the man with ball in hand wiping up a wet spot before he throws it up is Frank Scagliotta. We're just about set for 14th-ranked Georgia Tech against the 24th-ranked Commodores of Vanderbilt.
I thought Jimmy Higgins was going to come over and sit down with us.
Yeah, I know. He saw us by that table and saw those drinks in front of us. He was almost there. Frank's got everything straightened out. And it's Newville and Lawson to get us underway. Game two with Travis Best ball in hand.
Vanderbilt opens up man-to-man.
McCaffrey on Best. That could be a classic before the night is done.
Newville trying to set a screen for Best. Instead, he moves out to take the ball and initiate the offense.
Berry doesn't take the three. Had an opening. Down to 12 on the shot clock. They pack it into Forrest against Lawson.
Interesting matchup. They put Lawson on Forrest. A little bit of weight differential there.
Good defense by Vandy. Berry's going to have to be the guy to take it if he can get a shot off. Boy, that's not the way to open up the game. Offensively for Georgia Tech, 35 seconds expired.
I thought they passed up a couple of shots. I thought Berry had a couple, and I thought maybe Forrest could have made that one move around Lawson, decided not to do it. Now Vandy with a chance to take the lead.
I think you made a great point. Forrest was a little bit shocked that all of a sudden he had that big redhead in his way, and that altered his thinking a little bit on offense.
Yeah, you expected Lawson to guard Newville, but they didn't do that.
Here's McMahon. Best on him. McCaffrey wide open for a first shot, and clangs it off the front. More outlets to Drew Berry. Skips it over. Travis Best will try it through. Oh! Rebound, Lawson.
Boy, has Lawson been strong on the boards this year? 13 against Syracuse, 14 the other night.
Bobby McMahon. And everybody cold early. Malik Evans in close. His first score of the night.
Malik Evans. One of the things Bobby Cremins is worried about with this club is the fact that they're not a very good rebounding team. In fact, they've only out-rebounded one opponent this year.
McCaffrey, great job defensively, and he goes into the chairs we had until a couple of minutes ago.
Billy got our drinks over there. We asked him to save them over there.
At least we know the waitress. So Martise Moore will inbound. Travis Best will set it at the point.
Watch the alignment. Best handling the basketball. The screen's for Forrest. And now Dan Hall has switched off on Forrest. And losses on Newbill.
Martise Moore, too strong. And Hall saves it into McMahon. 2-0, Vandy. Boston in the paint. Fouled en route by Newbill.
When you watch Chris Lawson play, this is a young man who transferred from Indiana after his sophomore year and was not getting enough playing time, felt like he deserved more. He comes into Vanderbilt really an unknown because his numbers weren't very strong in Bloomington, but he came down there and really has established himself as a really terrific inside player for these Commodores.
Chris Lawson.
Right about the same amount of points per game as a year ago, but as Larry said, almost doubled his rebounding average, over 10 per game, averaging a double-double, and he misses his opening free throw.
Had a great game against Wake the other night with those 20 points and those 14 rebounds. In fact, that, as you said, those 14 are career high.
Got the second, 3-0, Vanderbilt.
And Commodore's going to come out with a little full court pressure. A 2-2-1, floating back. Lawson is the safety valve.
And Martise Moore just lost the handle, but last touched by one of the Vandy players. And they could hit ball on the way out of bounds.
Charlie McMahon with a good slap from behind.
Very nice feed to Forrest. James Forrest, first basket for Georgia Tech. Evans drops it off. Lawson now will put it up. Tough rebound by Hall.
See, that's what I was talking about. Bobby Kremen's really upset. And the guys he's upset with are Forrest, Moore, and Newbill. They're just not getting on the glass. Vanderbilt taking it to them early.
Forrest can't hit the turnaround from the baseline. And a foul on Newbill as McMahon came down with the ball. And that's a cheap one on Ivan Newbill.
I'll say one thing. Tech is undefeated in what is, used to be the Cotton States Classic, now the Kuppenheimer Classic, in this particular weekend. They've not lost a game since they've started this thing.
Well, Newbill with two quick fouls, and you almost thought that Eddie Alissima, the freshman, would come off the bench, and on cue, he is in there. 6'10", freshman. They give away a little bit of beef inside, but he is a leaper, and he's going to try to pick up Hall now defensively. 5-2, Vandy early. Berry now, McCaffrey, but McMahon open around the pick, and he nailed a three.
On an assist from McCaffrey. Vanderbilt ran their offense to perfection on that trip.
McMahon shows why he is the leading three-point shooter right now on this Vandy team. That's his 12th of the year. And all of a sudden, Vandy jumps out to a quick six-point lead. Travis Best had a hand in his face, didn't get it. Alissima keeps it alive. Martise Moore pulls up. Georgia Tech cold from the field to open up. Billy McCaffrey weaving through traffic. And Paul walks with it.
Traveling. Georgia Tech ball.
Georgia Tech struggling from the field. Only 1-for-6 while Vandy's at 50%.
Vandy's been changing defenses. They're back to the man-to-man on this trip. The last time it was a zone.
Forrest trying to get involved offensively.
Oh, look at Lawson block out inside. He wouldn't let Alissima hit anywhere near that basket.
Eddie's giving away about 50 pounds on that deal. Maybe more.
I love Lawson's nickname.
Hall with back-to-back turnovers. But Vanderbilt with a lead. 15:57 to go, first half.
It's just a card.
Yeah, right.
Top Stadium Club. It's extreme intensity. Extreme design. It's taking chances. It's Beam Team. It's a radical point of view. If you want to feel the game like this, you can't go just anywhere. You gotta go to the extreme. Top Stadium Club. It's extreme.
Tragic Moments, presented by the new Dodge. When a 6'6" David Robinson enlisted in the Naval Academy, he was an unmolded raw talent. Talk about military buildup. By his senior season at Annapolis, he'd grown into a dominating 7'1" center. The Admiral swept the boards and dominated on defense. But he also had a formidable array of offensive weapons. With his arsenal, David Robinson provided the midshipmen with many magic moments.
At Chrysler, we test crash an average of one vehicle every working day of the year. This is one of the reasons our new minivans meet all 1998 federal car safety standards today. Most companies would consider this an ugly way to show their cars. To anyone interested in safety, it's a beauty shot. Now save $500 during our minivan safety leadership sale.
Buzz is having a good time here at the Georgia Dome. His team not really doing that well yet. Trailing by 6 to the Vanderbilt Commodores. 8-2 Georgia Tech, ice cold from the field and being out-rebounded. As Larry talked about, that's been one of the problems for them. The Commodores with a 6-point lead, and Bobby Crimmins already has his forehead in hand. And there's the story on the boards.
His hair cannot get any grayer.
Right.
I mean, that's it. That's as far as it goes.
They gave that last ball to Vanderbilt, and that's what caused all the boos right before the break, because it looked like Hall just threw it away, and then it was touched by no one other than him. But it's Vanderbilt's ball baseline, and they've got it with a 6-point lead.
And Georgia Tech's back into a zone defense now. Looks like a 2-3, and they might match up out of this a little bit. Vandy recognizes it, and they put Lawson to the high post.
And Lawson will take a 15-footer over Alisma and nailed it.
You know what? I think he was looking to pass, but nobody came out to guard him, so he just turned around and shot a free throw.
10-2. Vanderbilt surprising Georgia Tech. Travis Best trying to get clear of McCaffrey. Worked in the paint, drew a foul, and McCaffrey got all of it. Travis Best will have an opportunity from the free throw line.
The foul is on Vanderbilt's Billy McCaffrey.
And for the first time, Vandy will go to its bench.
First.
Brian Milburn and Frank Secker will check in. And the breathers go to Hall and Evans. Travis Best, 86% from the free throw line so far in the year. And he has been the one guy that really has played well for Georgia Tech through their first six games. Everyone else a little bit spotty so far in their performance. Just when I talk about what a great free throw shooter he is, he clangs one off the front. 5'11 junior out of Springfield, Massachusetts, and he missed them both. You won't see that happen very often. Lawson pulls down the rebound. Now Best picks up Secker full court. Boy, Frank Secker's having to work for every dribble he puts on the floor. 15 minutes to go first half. 10-2 Vanderbilt with the early run on Georgia Tech. They double-team McCaffrey.
Three good guards out there. Secker, really a terrific sophomore. McMahon and Caffrey, the experienced ones.
Three on the shot clock as McCaffrey launches one. And we're going to have a foul inside, I believe, on Milburn. That'll be his first.
Interesting lineup Vanderbilt's got in there right now with McMahon, McCaffrey, and Secker, all three guards. And Lawson and Milburn, not really. I mean, Lawson's a post guy, but he's really only about 6'8 and a half, 6'9. And they go to his own defense, a 1-3-1, and Secker's going to play the point and put pressure on Best.
Georgia Tech brings in its number three scorer who has the ball right now, Fred Vincent. He's an excellent 3-point shooter, and Bobby Crimmins trying to maybe put some offense in his lineup here.
Yeah, that'll do it. There it is. That guy can burn the nets.
10-5. Fred Vincent, a lot of people around college basketball may not know that name. They might when the season's over. Lawson lost it as Forrest did a nice job defensively. Got some help from Alisma. And Tech comes down trying to cut the Vandy lead to 3. Vincent had a thought, but McMahon got out on him and stole the ball.
Good man-to-man defense by McMahon. Lawson trying to post inside. Now he's going to screen for Milburn. They'll try to find McCaffrey off this double screen. He decides not to use it.
Secker's a good 3-point shooter, too, for Vandy. He feeds Lawson on the drive. The score on a chance for three for Lawson. Boy, he knows how to use that 6'10 body of his.
You know, on offense, it's a choice. It's options you can use. This time, Secker gets the ball to Lawson. He's got two options, one the shot or two the pass. Milgram was wide open on the other side. Georgia Tech not coming back and helping. Good move by Lawson.
So Lisma picks up his first foul, and Redbone goes to the free throw line. There's his numbers on the season. 5 points so far tonight, trying to make it six, and does. And now Vandy again will go to the bench, and Chris Woods will come in, and Lawson, after making that three-point play, will get his first breather. 13-5, Vandy by eight.
Secker's responsibility now to guard best. Forrest trying to post up Milburn.
Forrest wants it. He's got one of Georgia Tech's two baskets so far. Vincent's got the other one. Vincent got three. Instead feeds Forrest, and now Lisma. Lost the handle, but last touch by Vandy.
That was a bad defensive move that time by Milburn to go out and try to double team. He left Forrest wide open on that block. If they could have gotten the ball to him, he was wide open to the hoop. Got to choose your double teams very cautiously.
Vincent penetrates. Left hander off the glass.
That's what Tech needs, Brad. They need a lift from this bench right now. Starters look like they're somewhat lethargic.
Now Vincent's giving it to him. He's got five of their 7 points. Secker, they gave up a three. He won't give up two. Short, though. Best. Lobs for Forrest.
Now, Brad, that'll tell you something about James Forrest. Any other year, he's in the air jamming that ball. He could not get off the ground to catch that to do it. He had to take it and just lay it in.
Nursing a bad Achilles, and it has really been Georgia Tech's Achilles heel, if you will, through six games so far. He just hasn't been able to jump, and you can see him almost limping out there. Yet they've got to go with him. And he's limping down court right now. And there you see the bandaged right lower leg down in the Achilles area of James Forrest, who actually put weight on in the offseason. He played on the USA select team that went to Europe, but he has come back. His body fat's down. His body is built up. This time he got a little bit more elevation. He still used the glass, though.
I'll tell you what, he's still going to get his points. I'll take about a 70% James Forrest over 100% other players.
You got that right. 13-11, Vandy. Georgia Tech cuts Commodore's lead to a couple. McMahon can't get it. Loose ball picked up by Vincent. Fred Vincent's played extremely well off the bench. Waits, takes a three. Not this time. And Milburn the rebound. McMahon. Best pulls it off the backside. He's a good rebounding guard. He knows where to be.
Got a great nose for the ball. And the basket.
And the drive. He got it. Dramatic shot for his first points, and we have got a tie game.
Travis Best is at his best in the open court. He is going down that floor with a basketball. Very reminiscent of two other great point guards, Bryce and Anderson. Boy, they were good at it, too.
8-0 Tech run. Woods misses the hook. Milburn with a follow, though.
And nobody there to contest it.
Yeah, Bobby Kremen says he thinks Travis Best is better than Mark Bryce. And Kenny Anderson. But, of course, those guys are making a lot of dough for the Nets and the Cavs right now. He'd get away with saying that. James Forrest warming up, though. He's got eight. 15-15. 10:50 to go first half from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. Our second of two. As sixth-ranked Kansas survived the second-half Georgia scare and beat the Bulldogs in our first game. Don't forget, we got two more games yet to come tonight on ESPN.
Tech with very little pressure against this Vanderbilt zone offense. They're going to back off and let them have the shot.
Under 10 on the shot clock. And Milburn doesn't look that aware of that. McMahon is, though. And he put it in the paint. That's a tough shot.
And Best was in his back, and Moore was in front of him.
Vandy by two. McMahon has five. Secker almost came up with a steal on Best. Travis needs some help.
Forrest with a good face-up.
rattled out on him. It was a good face-up. He's worked on that move a lot in the summer, trying to improve that shot from about that spot.
You know, the one thing I like about James Forsey, he continues to work on his game. Everybody tells him what a great player he is. He wants to constantly improve. Tell you what, he improved on those muscles. He worked on that weight room in the summer.
Milburn trying to feed the back door. Woods didn't make the cut. The steal from Martise Moore. Vincent backs up. Three-pointer. Got it.
Good look again by Best.
Vincent with eight off the Tech bench. And Georgia Tech has its first lead of the night.
Seems like on every trip down the floor, Travis Best is involved in the play. Either on the offensive end or defensive end, he's made two good passes and a pick layup. Yeah, Tech with the lead.
McMahon trying to answer, a little too stiff on that three-pointer. He may have pushed off with a rebound, but he got away with it. Evans on Vincent. Alisma having a look at McMahon. Roddy's open. Can't leave him there.
That's what I'm saying. You can't. You got to guard the guys that are the shooters. Right now, Vanderbilt's got two guys on the floor that are decent shooters. McMahon obviously is one, and Sager can shoot when he wants to. The other three guys are not that good of shooters.
Commodores by two. Travis Best found a little alley. Drew a foul.
Boy, there's a lot of ball, Brad.
What Coach Van Bredekoff said, too.
Foul is on Brian Milburn of Vanderbilt, his second.
Ronnie McMahon's got one of the picture-perfect jump shots in the Southeastern Conference, if not the country. Look at that follow-through, the extension, the little dip in the wrist, and the bottom of the net.
Ronnie McMahon with that number 23 jersey. Like many of these young guys, Michael Jordan, his idol, and that's the reason for that number on his back. There's Travis Best's numbers on the year. Got 3 points tonight, as you saw, averaging over 21 to lead Georgia Tech.
You think anybody will ever be seeing Michael who?
I don't think so. Got them both. Best with four. The game is deadlocked with 8.5 to play. First half, Vandy and Georgia Tech gets 20.
In 1992, we created the first integrated child seat for the minivan. Now we've improved it. We put the first airbag in the minivan. This year, we've added one for the passenger. In fact, we've improved over 2,400 parts on the new Dodge Caravan and Plymouth Voyager. They meet all 1998 federal car safety standards today. And where does that leave the competition? Now save $500 during our minivan safety leadership sale. Delta Faucet has over 1,000 different styles of faucets to choose from.
Wait, just a sec.
So there's a Delta Faucet that's right for everyone's needs.
Oh, okay, I'll get the food, you get the water.
Delta, the way water is brought to life.
And don't forget to turn it off.
One of the advantages of living in Atlanta, our players in the summertime, they get to play with a lot of the Hawk players and the pros who live in the city. And Ramil Robinson was really great that Fred took him under his wing a little bit and tried to help his game.
You know, one of the things when you get a shooter like Fred Vincent, you want to play him as much as you can. And Bobby Kremis took a big gamble with this guy last year and redshirted him, sat him on the bench, said, I'm going to bring you back your senior year. I'm going to need you more next year than I am this year. Well, he's come back, and he's come back very, very strong.
And he leads Georgia Tech along with Forrest with 8 points each. Tie game at 20.
Watch the pressure. Yeah, a little pressure that time by Georgia Tech. Vandy, no hurry to beat it. There's the man.
Back my hand squares up this time. Not quite. And Darryl Barnes the rebound. And McMahon, frustrated by, I think, the missed shot, picks up the foul. Ronnie's first.
Now on Vanderbilt's Ronnie McMahon. His first.
Dan Van Bredikoff, 41-year-old first-year coach for Vandy. There's a three-point shooting so far. Vandy struggling a little bit.
Haven't heard much from Billy McCaffrey. He's been over there for a little while back in the game.
That's been the story the first five games for Vanderbilt. And even though McCaffrey's averaging almost 17 and a half a game, it's not quite the same player we saw a year ago. And as Larry said, a lot of that has to do with being a marked man. Best for three. Secker the rebound.
Look out. And nobody there from Tech to even stop him. He had a wide open lane right down the baseline, and Hall went right for it. What, did he smell that basket?
Best on top. Vincent thought about it, tried to feed more, and it comes right back to him.
Vandy doing a nice job with their zone defense, trying to force Tech out.
Martiz Moore, and he nails one just inside the three-point line. Sophomore with his first basket.
Basket's good.
22 apiece. It's been about everything we expected so far. We expected a tight game, and although Vandy jumped out to a 10-2 lead, dead even right now with 7 minutes to go first half. Billy McCaffrey works for his shot. Vincent the rebound. Georgia Tech with a 4-on-2. Let's see if they can make it pay off. Best. Three-pointer. McMahon, tough rebound over Barnes and Vincent. Lawson squares up. Nails it.
Oh, that was pretty, wasn't it?
Yep.
Got the ball to the right side, and he got his feet underneath of him and made a nice shot. Good feed from McCaffrey.
Chris Lawson with 8. Vandy again back by 2. Drew Barry's been quiet. He's got the ball with McCaffrey on him. Martiz Moore feeling it. Nails a 3.
Dan Hall looked over Jan Van Bredikoff, the coach, and he says, what do I do? He said, just guard him.
Georgia Tech for the second time with a 1-point lead. Hall squares and nails it.
There's nobody guarding on the right side over here. Hall's gotten one. Lawson's gotten one.
Almost a steal. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Martiz Moore. That's his first. So Vandy with a nice job defensively. And with 5 minutes, 53 seconds, Bobby Kremins and Dan Van Bredikoff will get a chance to talk it over with their team. Vandy in front by 1.
Crystal, tell me about your workout routine.
Well, on Monday, I do the treadmill. And on Wednesday, I do the treadmill. And on Friday...
Don't tell me.
The treadmill.
Doesn't that get a little boring?
Well, yeah. Sometimes I feel like a hamster on one of those little wheels.
Yeah, and working out on just one machine isn't that good for you. Have you thought about cross-training? By alternating exercise routines each time, your muscles can work harder. They're not as tired, and you get more benefits.
Cross-training? Hey, Frank, can I get some of those meat shoes?
Oh, sure, Crystal. Then you can combine our 20-minute sprint circuit and our stair climber. Do an aerobics class and use free weights. We have the staff to teach you all about cross-training, the fastest way to total fitness. This holiday, give the gift of good health to yourself or a friend. A Q membership, just $24 a month for 24 months.
Can I still work out on the treadmill?
Of course, but we don't supply the hamster food.
Very funny, Frank.
A Q membership makes a great holiday gift, and right now it's a great value. Just $24 a month for 24 months. Call today.
See all the NFL action every Sunday. Sit back. Let us do the work. ESPN NFL Primetime. We'll find every bone-crushing hit, search out every key play, and mix insight from our pros into television's fastest hour of football. NFL Primetime. Tomorrow night at 7 Eastern, only on ESPN.
Tonight, Shaq's house in Orlando, taken over by the Seminoles and the Gators. Bobby Surf of Florida State with the steal and the dunk. It's a close ball game right now. The Seminoles up by 1 at halftime.
All right, Chris, thanks. Here it's Vandy by one with 5:53 left. And if somebody would have told Bobby Kremins he could go 14 minutes and hold Billy McCaffrey without a point, I think he'd probably be happy. Three-point shooting. Here's what it looked like a year ago for McCaffrey, McMahon, and Secker, and you see what they've done this season. So there's been a three-point shooting slump, and there's what we're talking about with Billy McCaffrey. 0-for so far.
A lot of times, Brad, that also begins to play head games with you a little bit. You want to make your club a little bit better. You know you average 20 points a game. You're a co-conference player of the year. And right now, he's just not getting it done for them. And he's a quality guy. It takes a lot of pride in what he does. Just got to let the game come to him.
McMahon. McCaffrey, nice hook pass out.
I'll tell you the one thing that hasn't suffered is his passing ability. He's done a nice job in the first half of delivering the basketball to the open man.
Forrest picks up McCaffrey. With five on the shot clock, Hall lets fly just inside the three-point line.
It's a two-point basket.
And Dan's got eight. The lead is three for Vandy. Forrest with a left hand. Hall got a piece of that. Billy McCaffrey has not scored, nor has Drew Berry. I don't think Berry's got an assist either. He leads Georgia Tech in that category. We're under 5 minutes in the half. Hall pulls up from 10. Didn't get the roll. Lawson strong with a rebound.
Good rebounding again by Vanderbilt inside. Nobody from Tech there to stop it. Well, Georgia Tech needs to get on that offensive glass. Vanderbilt's killing them with those second shots.
Lawson in double figures with 10. Forrest wheeling on Hall. Can't get it on the baseline. Here's the outlet to McCaffrey, two on one. McMahon and McCaffrey.
Good two-man basketball. Get the pass ahead to the man who's open. McMahon did them. Got it back to McCaffrey for the layup. Good work.
I think if there was not only 20 seconds remaining before we get into that four-minute TV timeout mark, Bobby Kremins might have taken one right there. He maybe should have. Vincent threw it away. 7-point Vandy lead. McCaffrey. No goaltending call on Martise Moore. Lost it in the follow. More of the rebound. That was close. Here comes Berry.
Boy, Van Beredikoff certainly wants it. And well, he should.
Berry slows it down. Forrest. Got it.
You just can't allow James Forrest to turn around and face the basket from 8 feet. He's just too good a shooter and too strong.
Forrest with 10. So does Lawson have 10. And it's 32-27. Vanderbilt.
Timeout.
We got a timeout with 3 minutes 37 seconds remaining in the half, and Vandy stretched it to a 5-point lead.
What's up, Helen? Guess I've had this Wolf Stanley about 6 years now. Boys, been through it. Been dropped, run over, beat up. You name it, it's been through it. Not another thermos anywhere that can take it like this one. See what I mean?
The Aladdin Stanley All-Steel Thermos, guaranteed for life.
A small touch, a certain look. It's the little things that are worth the most. Which is why every Delta faucet gives you more than you'd ever expect for the money. Giving you the money for those things you can't even put a value on. Delta, the way water is brought to life.
My dandruff and itch are awful. I'll try anything. Denerex tingles. Head and Shoulders doesn't.
Both have effective dandruff medicine, but Denerex has something extra that tingles.
That's why I started using Denerex. No flakes, no itch.
Denerex, the serious dandruff shampoo.
This Christmas, give something that will make them ho, ho, ho all year long. Give the new shower massage by Teledyne Waterpik.
Vanderbilt leads by five. There are two key ingredients to a fast break if you're going to run it. One is an outlet pass. That's the first one right there. Stop it right there. Take a look at Billy McCaffrey right here. His first look is to Ronnie McMahon. He makes the good, crisp pass right here. McMahon with the head up, looking back and saying, I've got you, Billy. Take it and lay it in. That's the way you run a good, clean, fast break.
Vandy by five. I question whether Martise Moore got away with a goaltending as McCaffrey went up. That's pretty nice. I take it back, Martise.
I think he got it, too. It was on the way up. Nice, nice block.
Vandy, their second chance points have been good to them. Georgia Tech doesn't have any. Vanderbilt with a dozen of them. And a 32-27 Commodore lead. Vandy with 8 offensive rebounds of the 18 they have so far in this half.
And Bobby Kremis with his final 330s asked his team to come out and put a little bit of pressure on Vanderbilt, which they haven't done so far. Interesting coaching change right here. I think it's a good idea.
All working against Moore. Forrest, that's a strong rebound. You heard the smack as he pulled it down, and here comes Travis Best. Berry almost walked with it. Nice no-look to Forrest to Alisma.
Well, those are 3 good passes right there. And the finish by Alisma.
Georgia Tech cuts it to 3. 3 to play, first half.
Bobby Turner's made a good move here, coming out, putting the pressure on Vanderbilt, and they're going to get another turnover.
Secker walked with it before he put up the shot. Georgia Tech, we talked about Vandy moving the ball well. Look at this trip for Georgia Tech.
Watch Berry right here. McCaffrey trying to draw the charge. Forget it. 1, 2. Boy, that was a terrific pass at the end right there. Did Forrest make a great cross-the-lane pass?
For Alisma, that's his first basket of the night. Georgia Tech with a chance to cut it to 1. A three-pointer would tie us up. Last touch by Secker.
Look, Martise Moore, I mean, Alisma almost got in trouble with that. He tried to pick that ball up, and it was going to go back to them.
So Moore will inbound.
Vanderbilt sitting back in that zone defense.
Travis Best thought about a three-pointer. Packs it inside to Forrest over Lawson.
I'll tell you what, Chris Lawson is right in his face, but it doesn't make any difference.
We mentioned earlier that Bobby Kremitz hoping James Forrest came to play. I'd say with 12 points in the first half and still 2 minutes 20 seconds to go, he had. Nice defensive job by Drew Berry to knock that pass away. We're 2 minutes and 17 seconds remaining in the first half, and 2 minutes 17 seconds away from our Delta Faucet halftime report. Top 25 scores and highlights. We'll take a look at Carolina and Ohio State, Indiana against Eastern Kentucky, and all the rest. Chris Fowler will have it for you in a couple of minutes. Brad Nessler and Larry Connolly with you at the Georgia Dome with Chris Lawson, and another easy one. They can't just let Lawson and Hall have their way down there.
No, Lawson is really having a terrific first half.
Lawson has 12.
So he and Forrest have really counteracted each other.
Martise Moore short on that three-pointer. 34-31. Vandy with a three-point lead. Nice cross-court pass by Milburn. And McMahon. Jumper won't go. Alisma tried to save it. Stepped on the line.
Tell you what happened on that play right there. It was a good move on the outside. Malik Evans just kind of stuck his hand in there and knocked it off of Alisma.
Been limited substitutions in this game, but that is, for the most part, the way these two teams will look throughout the year. They're not going to go too deep on the bench. Bobby Kremen's notorious for having a 6 or 7-man iron squad, I guess, just about every year.
Ooh, that's a bad pass right there. McMahon caught Lawson unaware.
Got to get a shot off. Did he? Frank Scagliata says yes. Second time we've had one of those tonight. We had one in game one.
That one was close, too.
Evans right at the horn.
Watch Forrest look over his shoulder. Good square up.
Oh,
he
man.
Is so tough. He is so tough.
14 for James Forrest. A minute to play. First half, Vandy by 3. McMahon gave up a three-pointer and fed Lawson. Goaltending pinned by Alisma.
Every time Forrest scores, Lawson scores. Watch this move by Forrest. Now watch. He's got it easy tonight. He looks. He sees Milburn. Forget it. Forget the hand. I'm going to shoot it in. This guy is so good. Think he's got a good body to play in the NBA?
He's got a shot? He can play in the NFL, man.
you like it for that tight end.
I really do. 5-point Vanderbilt lead. And there's about a 15-second difference. Game clock and shot clock. That's the game clock in the corner. Berry has not scored yet. Trying to work for a shot. McCaffrey picks him up.
Forrest follows Alisma's miss.
Oh, what a follow.
I think his Achilles is getting warmed up. 38-35. Vandy will play for the final shot. McMahon looks up at the clock.
That was unbelievable.
Here's McMahon, ball in hand. Final shot from Ronnie. No good. Rebound, Georgia Tech. They won't get a shot off. But boy, did they get a follow shot a few seconds ago from number 34. Let's just sit back as we go to our halftime with Tech trailing by three. Ouch. Sometimes you can see the forest and the trees and forest with a big bucket, but Tech still trails by three as we head to Chris Fowler at halftime.
Brad, Larry, thank you. Big James Forrest trying to ignite that big crowd and the Yellow Jackets, but they trail Vanderbilt by 3 points at halftime. When we get going on the Delta Faucet Halftime Report, we'll have scores and highlights from the top 25. Carolina and Ohio State playing an excellent ball game this afternoon. We'll also have the night scores and the latest in a very big day of college basketball right here, a quadruple header. Right now, game number two of four, as we told you, the Jackets down by three to Vandy.
Your parents told you to do it. Your teachers begged you to do it. Your boss ordered you to do it. And now, we dare you to do it. Dare to compare Panasonic portable audio gear to the other guys and decide for yourself. Because the way to choose great sound is to shut up and listen.
Don't make me tell you again.
Panasonic sound. Dare to compare.
Jim was going where no man had ever gone, into the darkest jungles of Malaysia.
You find it, Jim?
Yeah.
Thought you could use a cold one.
Great. Ice cold O'Doul's. Not alcohol, and hey, only 70 calories. Just right for a true adventurer like Jim. Jim was going where no man had ever gone.
When you want the refreshing taste of beer without the alcohol, think O'Doul's. It's what beer drinkers drink when they're not drinking beer.
It's the same, and it's different. It's new Hershey's Hugs. Hugs are mini Hershey's Kisses hugged by white chocolate. New Hershey's Hugs. P.S. Hugs also come with almonds.
If you can dream it, the Rebel can do it. Now, EOS Rebel from Canon has more power to create images, not just snapshots.
Images is everything.
EOS Rebel and Rebel S from Canon. So advanced, it's simple.
Look. Keeps time, and it grates cheese.
While some watchmakers brag about their new inventions,
it is a stopwatch and mousetrap.
Loris makes practical watches, like the Loris Vector series. Rugged precision timepieces, equipped with their own direction finders, so you'll always know where you're headed. So forget
the new Press Spray 9000. Quartz accuracy never tasted as good.
Find your way with a Vector from Loris.
Hi, and welcome to the Delta Faucet Halftime Report with Vanderbilt up by 3 points on Georgia Tech at the break. Top 25 scores and highlights. Number one, Arkansas. They only average 109 points a game. Their average margin of victory, only 38 points so far this season. But Jackson State in the early going, hanging tough, a two-point Arkansas lead, but it is very early at the Bud Walton Arena. This afternoon at the Dean Smith Center, number two, North Carolina, going for a sixth consecutive victory since that loss to UMass. Taking on Lawrence, Funderburk, and the Buckeyes. In the second half, Ohio State is hanging tough. Funderburk, the great pass, Nate Wilborn with the finish. It's tied at 58 with 7 minutes to go when Donald Williams steps up for Carolina. The bench knows the three is good. Then Williams on the little drive in the banker. Williams taking his man off the dribble down the lane. And Williams one more time working that right side with a short jumper. He scored 12 straight points for Carolina. 16 points in a six-minute span and ended up with 26 points as the Tar Heels pull away 81-68 over Ohio State. Kansas and Georgia meeting earlier this afternoon at the Georgia Dome. Hugh Durham trying again for career win number 500. He was unsuccessful in his first try. Richard Scott and the Jayhawks now sitting down on the job in the early going, but Jacques Bond drives the lane, the layup, and it was a three-point Kansas lead in the early going. In the second half, the Jayhawks finally pull away. B.J. Williams on the block. Steve Woodbury down the court. The freshman Vaughn caps it off with the layoff. And the Hawks had an eight-point lead. Vaughn had 17. Hugh Durham's team committing 27 turnovers. He's 0 for 2 in his attempts to get that win number 500 as Kansas wins it at the Kuppenheimer Classic. Louisville and Wyoming, Denny Crum's Cardinals once beaten on the season, ranked number 10, traveling to the thin air of Laramie, Wyoming, and needing some oxygen at 7,000 feet. That's Alvin Sims. In the first half, Theo Ratliff around his man and throws it down for the Pokes. But Louisville, some good D. Clifford Rozier makes the steal. The acrobatic outlet to Greg Minor. Yeah, he takes about four steps. They don't call it and the dunk. Cardinals up 9 at the break. More Rozier in the second half. David Murray, get it out of here. And Denny Crum's team eventually pulls away and makes it look pretty easy. 72-55 over Wyoming as the Cardinals improve to 4-1. Rozier, 14 boards, and he had 18 points. We're going to continue on the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report with more scores and highlights. The Hoosiers in action, and Damon Bailey, would he have a Sports Illustrated cover jinx? I don't think so. We'll show you in a minute.
This Halftime Report is presented by the Delta Fawcett Company. Delta, the way water is brought to life.
Delta Faucet has over 1,000 different styles of faucets to choose from.
Wait, just a sec.
So there's a Delta Faucet that's right for everyone's needs.
Oh, okay, I'll get the food, you get the water.
Delta, the way water is brought to life.
And don't forget to turn it off.
Cheers. Champagne's not Corbel.
Corbel, for people who know champagne.
Are your kids wishing for something exciting? Radio Shack has it with action-packed radio-controlled cars. Kids control rough terrain with our Force One Rally. The new off-road Tiger lets them handle hills and straightaways. The Scorpion Track Racer is hard to beat, and the Flamethrower is really hot. Now all you have to control is their excitement. For a great selection of this year's hot gifts, check out Radio Shack, your Christmas electronics store.
Why do we do this every year? Wait till the last minute to shop for the holidays.
What do we give Mom and Dad?
Let's give Dad his lucky brother.
Yeah, the kids are upstairs.
Let's wrap the ice cream.
Foot Locker.
It's easy.
I'm gonna give you to Mommy.
Reebok, Fila, Nike.
Oh, hon, don't look. I just found your gift.
You're my favorite fish, and I'm gonna wrap you up.
Do you have these cowboy jackets in small?
Michigan for Keith, Notre Dame for Gary.
Wrap the toaster.
You think they got us something?
Get the dog.
Get the boy.
And we roll on with the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report. The Indiana Hoosiers taking on Eastern Kentucky with that 34-game home court winning streak at Assembly Hall. Damon Bailey, you know about the Sports Illustrated cover. Bob Knight hoping he would step up again. The Knights never lost to an OVC team. In the first quarter, Alan Henderson, the big throwdown. 14 points, 14 boards for Henderson. But Bailey, again, playing like Knight hoped he would coming out of high school. Takes the pretty feed from Todd Leary. And Steve Hart can also get up. The Thunder dunk off the miss by Henderson. Indiana had a six-point lead at the break, and then Damon Bailey would take over in the second half. Leary, the nice speed again. Bailey, 32 points, and Indiana now 10-0 all time against Ohio Valley Conference. Teams 5-1 on the season, and Bailey, again, 32 points, second time in less than a week he's had that many. Georgia Southern taking on Glenn Robinson and the 11th-ranked Boilermakers of Purdue this evening. It was Porter Roberts off the miss early on here, but the save by Glenn Robinson, who does it all here. And, yeah, a little head fake, and he throws down the short jumper. Purdue had an early four-point lead. Then on the break, Brandon Brantley, the block. Porter Roberts eventually comes up with the ball at the other end, and right now at Mackey Arena in the early going, the Boilermakers. No trouble at this point, a seven-point lead. They played 5 minutes. Purdue 11-0 in December games since Glenn Robinson arrived. Illinois also in the top 25, ranked number 19, taking on Chicago State at Assembly Hall in Champaign. We have a highlight from this ball game. It's Shelley Clark down in the block, gets the short shot to go, and right now the Illini lead by a dozen over Chicago State. Illinois won last year's meeting by a whopping 27 points. Also in the top 25, Cincinnati ranked 17th, taking on Youngstown State, a team which just won the national championship in football in 1AA today, but 10-6, it's the Bearcats with a four-point lead. Syracuse ranked number 21, taking on Maryland Eastern Shore, 11:50 to play in the first half. It's the Orangemen with a nine-point lead. And GW, Yinka Dare and Company, battling Pepperdine in the nation's capital tonight, a 32-30 lead for the Colonials at the break. Dare had 9 points in the first half. We'll continue in a minute as we go to break. More scores in the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report. The Gators of Florida trying to start out 6-0 this season. The first time in 10 years, a four-point lead over the Seminoles in Orlando.
Sure, there's lots of barbecue places in Memphis, and everyone claims to have the best. But if you love barbecue like we do, there's only one place to go, the Pig and Whistle. Take it from us, when it comes down to taste, nobody beats the Pig and Whistle. Right, honey? Honey?
Hmm? Have you tried Pig and Whistle ribs? They're incredible. Pig and Whistle Barbecue, 2740 Bartlett Road and 7144 Winchester.
Let Lady Luck Casino stuff your Christmas stocking with holiday cash. It's all part of Lady Luck Casino's 12 Days of Christmas $40,000 cash giveaway. Each of the 12 days before Christmas, Lady Luck Casino is giving away thousands of dollars in cash to lucky winners. Plus, tickets to the 1993 Liberty Bowl. Register for all of the drawings. But don't miss the big one on Christmas Eve for $12,000 and four tickets to the Liberty Bowl. It's Lady Luck Casino's 12 Days of Christmas $40,000 cash giveaway.
Welcome back to the Delta Fawcett Halftime Report as we roll on with more scores. The Blue Demons, 7-point winners over Jacksonville this evening. St. Louis, a 3-point victory over Murray State. West Virginia leading Ohio U by 11 points in the second half. St. Bonaventure, the early lead over Niagara. Richmond, 11 points up on VCU in the first half, and it's a final. Evansville has beaten Kent by 33. Valparaiso pounding Dartmouth, 154. Penn over Haverford by a huge margin. Coming up, LSU and UCLA, two unbeaten teams following Vanderbilt and Georgia Tech from Pauley Pavilion. Then following SportsCenter, number 13 Arizona looks for payback after the huge upset in the tournament for the Broncos of Santa Clara midnight Eastern Time. At halftime, Vanderbilt up by three on Georgia Tech, and Ronnie McMahon with the long three. Commodores going into the Georgia Dome and playing well in the first half.
Hey, it's time to get live on Prodigy. Don't you hate guys who think they know it all about sports? Your brother-in-law, Phil, wish you could beat Phil in his own game. Get on Prodigy and get sports experts like Dick Schaap, Fred Edelstein, and ESPN's Peter Gammons. We've got stats, insights. We know what's going on with just about every team in sports. Next time you see old Phil, rattle off everything you learned. He doesn't have to know where it came from. Call 1-800-PRODIGY and get live on the Prodigy service.
I'll tell you where the time goes. Every year I spend 3,000 hours sleeping, 500 hours commuting, 2,000 hours working. Then I get this idea, boing. Every day for lunch I order one of McDonald's extra value meals. Now, I'm not only saving money, I'm in and out so fast, I figure I'm saving 5-6 hours a week, huh? That's nearly 2 weeks of free time a year. So, in 12 months, I'm gonna have all this extra cash, plus 2 extra weeks. And right now, I'm thinking Hawaii.
What you want is what you get.
What?
At McDonald's today.
Citibank has really given us a new sense of self because we have our own identities.
I have a Citibank Visa card, and it does have my photo on it, so I have one less worry.
And not only that, but you can pick what you like, so it doesn't look like a DMV photo.
I don't know why the other credit cards aren't doing the same thing. We need a photo card so family members can tell us apart.
Introducing the first credit card with your photo and signature on front from not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
Yeah. Good. What's up, Helen?
Okay.
Guess I've had this old Stanley about 6 years now. Boys, been through it. Been dropped, run over, beat up. You name it, it's been through it. There's not another thermos anywhere that can take it like this one. See what I mean?
The Aladdin Stanley All-Steel Thermos, guaranteed for life.
ESPN's exclusive coverage of NCAA basketball is brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers, who reminds you, friends know when to say when.
Friends know when to say when, Buzz. I'm glad Buzz wasn't our waiter tonight. Halftime, Vandy leading Georgia Tech 38-35. Brad Nessler and Larry Conley back in Atlanta. Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. Second of our two games, Kansas a winner over Georgia in the first one. We talked all about the guard play in this one coming into it, Larry. It's been the inside play for Vandy and Georgia Tech that has them where they are.
That's
right
how
now.
Much we know, right?
Yeah, right.
Let's take a look at some of that inside play, too, because it's been Lawson and really Forrest who've carried the load. Watch the aggressiveness right here of Chris Lawson. Missed, got it, went back, bounced, and went right back up again. That's seven rebounds in the first half. That was two of them right there. Now watch Travis Best get the ball inside to James Forrest. It's been an inside game. In the paint, Georgia Tech is 10 of 11, and Vanderbilt is 10 of 15, and it's been Forrest and Lawson that have carried the load.
And if you miss James Forrest on this one, yeah, a little bit of authority on that putback. And Forrest leading Georgia Tech in scoring, and 52% for the Yellow Jackets from the floor. And you see the big rebounding edge for Vanderbilt. And that's got to be driving Bobby Kremins crazy, as Larry talked about earlier. Look at the second chance points, 14-2. So that's the edge for Vandy. They have the lead, and they have the ball. And the big men have done all the damage. Forrest, 16 and 3 boards for Georgia Tech, and Lawson with 14 at intermission. You just get the feeling, though, that you can't bottle these guards up throughout the game.
Let me talk about those guards for just a minute, Brad, because when you talk about Billy McCaffrey, he was 1 of 5. Best was 1 of 5. 4 assists for McCaffrey and 5 assists for Best, so the rest of their game hasn't suffered because their scoring hasn't been there.
Those rebound numbers for Lawson in the first half, he had as many rebounds as the Tech starters combined. Wow. McCaffrey works for his shot. It won't drop. Marquise Moore the rebound. Best pulls up, nobody picked him. Like I said, you just get the feeling at some point the guards will contribute. Best with the first basket of the second half. It's a 1-point game.
Georgia Tech's in the man-to-man defense. And they've got Newbill back in the lineup. He only played 3 minutes in the first half.
McCaffrey got around Newbill and buried it.
You think they heard us talking about him at halftime? McCaffrey and Best get the first two baskets of the second half.
40-37, Vandy. Forrest kicks it out to Moore. Berry did not score in the first half. Moore, 3. Berry trying to hustle for the rebound, kicked it right to Lawson.
Nice bounce pass by McMahon. A better pass by McCaffrey, and they missed it.
Maybe too good. I think that one surprised Paul, but Vandy will get another chance.
Oh, what? Two great passes.
I think Hall thought that shot was going to be taken, and he almost ended up with some chin music on that pass.
Yeah, you got to be ready to receive passes like that. I mean, a guy like McCaffrey, you know if he's not going to take the shot, you're going to get the ball in a good position.
Evan, his 3 rattles out. Forrest clears it off. Best with an extra burst of speed around McCaffrey. Didn't get the shot, and a push-off on Newbill underneath. That'll be 3 on Ivano Newbill. That's been one of his troubles, really, over his stay at Georgia Tech. Foul trouble, 3 right now.
Right, there's going to be problems with this Tech club this year. It's going to come from the inside. They really need help from Daryl Barnes and Ivano Newbill. They've got the perimeter players. That's not what they're concerned about. For this club to be successful in the ACC this year, they've got to have the play from those two big guys.
Remember, Malcolm Mackey graduated and was drafted by the Phoenix Suns, and he was a double-figure rebounder every game and usually got you about 16 points as well. Turnover. There have been very few in this game, unlike our first game. Taylor, we only had four turnovers apiece in the first half for each club. That's outstanding. Best, he's clear again. That one came out. Evans the board.
Boy, it's really rare to see Travis Best miss an open, wide open jump shot like that.
Hall with a turnaround over Forrest. Lawson, great position. The hook. 16 for Lawson. Forrest down the run. He got assaulted and it still went in. How strong is that? We saw the strong moves by both big guys. They're talking to each other a little bit now. Well, let's show you both.
Chris Lawson weighs 264. He's going to get up and get this rebound and stick back on the Hall miss. There's another rebound, his eighth. The little jump hook right over Forrest. Now, what's the other end? This is 264 pounds coming down on you. And Forrest says, forget it, big guy. I'm going to stick it anyway. And then they had a few words.
Forrest himself goes about 258 and a chance for a three-point play. And they're still sort of staring at each other. He is on his season average already.
Well, that would be a heavyweight duel.
Sure would be. I wouldn't want to be the ref in the middle of that one. 42-40 Vanderbilt. They have virtually led throughout this game. Their biggest lead was 8 points in the first half. Georgia Tech's had a couple of one-point leads, and that's it. McMahon gave up a three. Caffrey, kind of a dangerous entry. Outlet, Best to Berry on the run. That's what he did against Georgia the other night over Shandon Anderson.
I think he's jacked, McMahon. He didn't think he was going to dunk the ball. He thought he was going to block it.
Same identical thing happened Wednesday night in the Georgia Tech-Georgia game, only it was on Shandon Anderson, and Berry has tied it at 42. No basket.
No basket.
Foul on Forrest in low.
Drew Berry right down the middle on the steal. Watch Best with the lead pass right here. Good kick out. Now watch Berry. He's going strong. Forget it. McMahon didn't believe it.
Tell you what, he looks slightly built, but he's tough as a day-old pretzel. And he has tied it at 42.
Oh, what a perfectly run out-of-bounds play.
McCaffrey with six. Vandy again with a two-point lead. Vincent back in there. He gave Tech the spark in the first half with his scoring from the outside. Forrest squares up. A little too strong on that one. Vincent and Moore may have knocked each other off that would-be rebound.
Yeah, but at least they're going to the glass, which was something they weren't doing in the first half.
That's a good point. Look at Lawson and Forrest. Lawson lost the handle. Berry between his legs to Forrest. The no-look back to Forrest with a left hand. And James Forrest is pulled up lame. Forrest with the bad Achilles, and I don't know if it's that or if it's the left leg, but he pulled up down on the baseline. He'll have a chance to rest it. A timeout with 15:52 to go, and the Commodores by a pair.
You may have made a difference in someone's life. We can't tell you their name or anything about them. We can tell you that by using or being a designated driver, like 80 million other Americans, you've made a very real contribution. You see, drunk driving fatalities declined by 32% in the last 10 years. We salute America's designated drivers, and we urge everyone to join you. By doing what's right, you're making things better. A message from Anheuser-Busch.
Panasonic presents a unique and highly evolved smooth operator. The new Smooth Operator 2 with float control is the only razor to unite the comfort of twin independent floating heads with the closeness of a warm, wet shave. Don't try this with any plugged-in razor. The new Smooth Operator Wet Dry Razors from Panasonic. Smoother than you ever thought you'd be.
When they told him he didn't have the size to play, he reached inside and found the power.
Starter.
He was from a small school in a small town. But he had the heart to make it big.
Starter.
Each had a dream. And when you start with a dream, where you end up is up to you.
Starter.
Vanderbilt by two, just under 16 to play. Billy McCaffrey this year, as Larry Connolly so aptly put it, is a marked man, and his coach knows it.
Every team is going to either be, concentrate on him, whether it be a box on one or a switching man-to-man. They're going to know where he is at all times, and it's going to make it difficult for him to score. He's worked very hard in the last 10 days since our last game of getting open and getting his feet ready and his hands ready to shoot the ball as he comes off a screen.
And McCaffrey has responded with 4 points in this half, six for the game. It's been the inside play of Lawson and Forrest that have done most of the damage in this ball game.
19 points for Forrest so far on 9 of 16 field goal shooting, with only 3 rebounds.
Lawson with 16 points and 8 boards.
Two big lumberjacks have been going at it down in the paint.
They really have. Here's McCaffrey. Still having a little bit of trouble finding it.
See, he's not very far off, Brad. His shots aren't missing a lot. They're just a couple of inches off.
Best with Secker on him. Best wheels and got it.
What a shot. Frank Secker did everything he could possibly do on that defensive sequence, and it didn't do him any good at all. Best still stuck it in.
Tied at 44. Hall hooks it out to McMahon. He's been kind of quiet this half. Secker will pull up for a two-pointer. Scramble for the rebound. Lawson got it. His ninth. McMahon's three is a brick. Georgia Tech with a chance to lead.
Oh, I think he got away with a double dribble right there.
Best outside. Tech does lead. You just get the feeling the guards will start to become a factor. They have. Georgia Tech 46-44. The other guard, McCaffrey, trying to answer. McMahon saved it to Secker somehow. McCaffrey off glass. The follow by Lawson.
And another rebound and tip in. Well, Lawson having a terrific game.
Double-double for Lawson. 18 points, 10 boards for the big redhead.
Two terrific saves that time by Vanderbilt to keep that ball alive.
Vincent almost had it swiped away from behind by McMahon. Right now, Best is the guy with a hot hand for Georgia Tech. Berry, three, yes.
Brad, they need somebody to get involved in the scoring right now besides Forrest and Best. And if Berry can step up and do that, you can see Tech begin to pull away from this club. Vanderbilt right now needs a basket. They need a confidence basket.
Crowd still very subdued. This is Georgia Tech's biggest lead, but it's only 3 points. McCaffrey. That one went halfway in and came out. And let's see.
They're going to count it. They're going to say it was in the cylinder.
They're going to say Forrest had his hand in the ring, and the basket goes. So McCaffrey gets the basket, and 8 points for Billy. Forrest will get a breather. Georgia Tech will put more of the burden, you would think, now on Vincent and Best to score, because Forrest is sitting and Newbill is not an offensive threat. Best, well, he maybe put too much pressure on himself. That wasn't the greatest shot he's taken tonight.
McCaffrey looks much more alert this half than he did in the first half.
Under 13 minutes to play in this one. Number 14 Georgia Tech, number 24 Vanderbilt. Each coming in with only one loss, and it has been tight the whole way. Tech right now with a one-point lead. Milburn, tough look in and out there. And Newbill, nice job to save that rebound.
6'11 broad jump.
Newbill trying to follow, missed the slam. Dan Van Bredekoff right now says, hey, guys, let's cool it a little bit. Slow down and get your bearings. And Secker does that.
The pace of the game has picked up substantially since the first half.
McCaffrey kicks it out to Secker. He goes right back inside to Evans. Tough rebound by Drew Berry. And Barry will push the tempo for Georgia Tech. Moore.
Well, Tech just not getting good offensive production on those last two trips. Now Vanderbilt's going to pull it back out and play a little more saner game.
They trail by one with 11 and a half to go in the ball game. Under 10 on the shot clock. Evans, good move on the baseline, couldn't get it to go, and Newbill tough on the rebound.
That's what Tech needs right now. They need Newbill on that backboard.
Vincent from downtown.
Well, Tech just can't make one. They can't get a shot to drop.
Their last four trips have been empty. Crowd starting to make some noise, and I'm not sure if it's the Vandy folks or the Tech folks wondering about a precarious one-point lead that has just become a one-point deficit. McCaffrey, 10 for the game now, and it's 50-49 Vandy. Push as Martise Moore was trying to work for a shot. It'll go on Brian Milburn, his third.
Brian Milburn, his third.
Billy McCaffrey's going to get a rest, his first this half.
Second.
10:42 to go in the ball game. A one-point Vandy lead.
After this evening's exciting double.
If you're tired of those automobiles that isolate, insulate, and virtually remove you from the outside world, may we recommend the new Defender from Land Rover. It can make life a bit more exciting.
No, the champagne's not Korbel.
Korbel, for people who know champagne.
Hit it.
If you want to feel the music, you've got to have great speakers. Radio Shack's Optimus speakers can surround you with theater sound. Or put a command performance on your bookshelf, in your living room, or on the road. Come audition over 80 speakers that deliver great sound, no matter what kind of music you listen to. Only at Radio Shack, your Christmas electronics store.
An update from Arkansas, where Jackson State is hanging with the Hogs. Watch the pretty play here. Roger Crawford to the big guy, Corliss Williamson, to Corey Beck. One, two, fakes, gets it up and down. Scotty Thurman is back in the ballgame. He'd left with a sprained ankle. Hogs by 10.
Chris, here's a one-point Vandy lead with 10 minutes, 42 seconds remaining from the Georgia Dome. With Larry Connolly, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The second of four basketball games for you on ESPN tonight.
They're going to fly us off to do the other two?
I don't think we can get a flight out. A couple of good ones coming up, though. This has been everything we expected. Forrest working inside against Milburn.
Must be SEC day. We've got Georgia, Vanderbilt, LSU's on tonight with UCLA.
Right. Now to 10 on the shot clock. Nice defense by the Commodore. Somebody's got to put one up. Barry is fouled. And that is tough to play that good of defense, as you said, and then come up with something that cheap. As Chad Tron got the foul.
And that's exactly what Jan Van Bredekamp was thinking right now. My goodness, we play 32 seconds of tough defense, and then we commit a foul like that. And I don't think really they're going to get a good shot off.
McCaffrey replacing Secker.
Secker sits. Billy McCaffrey is brief. Stay on the bench over. Inbound to Best. A nice pick, but he couldn't get the jumper.
Travis having difficulties. He missed his last four shots.
Oh,
Well, Vanderbilt getting very patient on offense. The last two trips, they really haven't forced it at all.
Nice cross-court pass.
Chad Sharone.
Three-pointer. Vandy by four. Berry rattled it out. Vincent kept it alive, steps out, toes on the line, and comes up short. But Tech will get a third chance.
I'll tell you, as best he could, Chris Woods tried to block Forrest off, and it didn't do any good.
Forrest, they've got to get him involved again. Newbill. Turn around jumper. How about Newbill?
Huh?
First basket of the game for Ivano Newbill. We said not much of an offensive threat, but that was a good-looking move. 53-51, Vanderbilt. That three-pointer comes off. McMahon is standing dead in his tracks to get an easy one. McCaffrey, he
got it over Newbill. Billy McCaffrey, much better in the second half than he was in the first.
He's just not going to hold guys like he and Travis Best down forever. I don't care how good a defense you play.
Vandy's got to a 1-3-1 zone defense now.
Best's one spot hand has gone cold, though, and Tech needs it from somewhere else. Berry, his second three of the half. One-point game.
Both clubs playing zone defense, and Georgia Tech also in the zone.
Woods wheels on Newbill. That was a sweet move with a left hand.
Nice crossover. Good fake. Newbill took it, and he went up with a left hand.
Commodores lead the Yellow Jackets by three, and we're down near the eight-minute mark. Vincent trying to follow. Tech with three chances, and still no basket in Vanderbilt ball. Bobby Kremen said, hey, wait a minute, we can't buy one. His team's down by three with 7:58 to go.
This place. It's the new Burger King Everyday Value Menu, featuring the one-of-a-kind, great big, great tasting flame broiled Whopper for only 99 cents. Get it in your favorite Burger King foods at new, lower, everyday prices.
It's sure helping my budget.
Check your Burger King for their everyday low prices, and be sure to try the number one preferred burger, the delicious flame broiled Whopper for only 99 cents. Value every day. Have it your way.
I love this place.
Everyday value. Is life great or what?
With Jim Karras Nissan, 2110 Covington Pike in Memphis. Not only are we the largest Nissan dealership in Tennessee, but Nissan Motor Sales of America just announced that we lead the nation in increase in sales at 85%. And here is just one of the reasons why. A 1994 Altima GXE. Automatic air, power everything, dual airbags, and more for only $15,477 or zero down $238 a month. Come see us at Jim Karras Nissan in Memphis.
More about sports than her. She participates. Her interviews are great. She's knowledgeable on the air. She's bubbly. She's exciting.
So glad to have her.
Great, great person. Gonna do really well on that show. I'm glad she's hosting it. She is working with Keith, though, isn't she?
Keith.
Keith Olbermann and Susie Colber. Sports Night.
This is the guy with the glasses, right? Mustache.
And Billy McCaffrey finally living up to his billing with 10 second half points. Watch this excellent shot over 6-11, Ivano Newbill. Billy McCaffrey beginning to light it up for these Commodores.
A couple of different halves for Billy McCaffrey. 1 for 5 in the first half, and he has answered the call as we expected him to in the second half. He's got 10 points and has gone 5 for 9 from the field, while James Forrest has cooled down a little bit. Remember Forrest, when he was trying to save a ball on the baseline, went down and came up limping a little bit. He took a brief rest. I don't believe he has scored, and maybe hasn't had a rebound since that point either. Now, whether or not that Achilles is really bothering him, we'll never know until the game's over. Right now, his team trails Vanderbilt by three, and the Commodores have the ball with 7:47 to play in the ballgame.
Brent, I'll tell you who else has cooled off is Travis Best. Georgia Tech back into that zone defense. McCaffrey still high.
Oh, yes, he is. 14 for Billy the Kid, and the lead is 5.
McCaffrey.
And now Georgia Tech in desperate need of some offense. Best is double team. Dangerous cross-court pass. Alisma, the freshman. Morris tried to follow that one and couldn't quite get it home. Marquise Moore for three.
Good thing he didn't get the two. They got an extra point out of it.
Marquise Moore with eight. 59-57.
And Tech switching defenses now. They're in a straight man-to-man. Best is on McCaffrey. This is a good matchup right here. Good screen. He's got it.
Oh, boy, does he ever.
McCaffrey.
6:50 to play. McCaffrey has given Vanderbilt again a four-point lead.
Forrest calling for the ball. He's got Hall inside. I'd go to him now. He got 3 points early. He hasn't done much since.
He had 16 in the first half. Here he is from 14. That one comes out on it. McCaffrey pushes it to Hall if he can get there. He saved it to McMahon.
Good decision by McMahon.
He has played a smart basketball game. Lawson fouled inside.
McCaffrey continues his hot hand. Watch Lawson get him the basketball. The nice screen right there by Sharon. He got it right into the basket. Boys, he had a hot second half.
Attention, please, Brian Gallagher.
Seven field goals this half for Billy McCaffrey.
You know what I like about him? The way he squares up on his shot. He turns, he looks at the basket. Everything. He really squares up nicely on the basket. Gets his feet in good position. The good follow through, it's all there.
He's 7 of 11 this half. This guy was the first half for Vanderbilt. 18 and 11 for Chris Lawson. Finished third in the Mr. Basketball voting as a high school senior in Indiana. And when you finish even in the top five of the Mr. Basketball voting in that state, you've had quite a high school career. He's got 19 points. The lead is 5 for Vanderbilt. Georgia Tech sort of on their home turf. Their campus just a couple of miles down the street from the Georgia Dome, which is where we are with 28,000
169
on hand.
Yeah.
Barry stepped on the line. Georgia Tech with the turnover. Coming up, more college basketball tonight on ESPN. Brothers O'Bannon lead UCLA against number 25 LSU. That's our matchup at 9:30, and that should be a dandy like the two we've had already. Georgia Tech's crowd trying to get into it. They know this game is slipping away. 62-57 Vanderbilt. We're under 6 minutes.
Bobby Crimmins has asked his troops to come out and put a little bit more pressure on this Commodore Navy.
Nice feed into Lawson. Fouled from behind by Barry.
Fouls on Drew Barry. His first.
Well, Lawson gets great position inside. With that wide body of his at 264, once you get it down in there, he's going to get it in.
Fresh 35 on the shot clock. They don't need much shot clock. McCaffrey,
he's in a zone. He's in a zone.
Billy McCaffrey has single-handedly turned this whole game in Vanderbilt's favor. Billy the Kid has got both pistols loaded, and it's 65-57.
Oh, my back hurts, and I had a game this afternoon, so I'm taking Advil. More doctors recommend Advil by name to relieve back aches than any other brand. With Advil, a sore back won't keep me from swinging. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
Let Long John Silver's brighten your holiday season with sparkling crystal. Collect stemware, our coffee mug, or our beautiful new dessert plate, each just 99 cents with any meal.
Long John Silver!
Why do we do this every year? Wait till the last minute to shop for the holidays.
What do we give Mom and Dad?
Let's give Dad his lucky brother.
Yes, the kids are upstairs.
Let's wrap the ice cream. Let's have the ice cream.
Foot Locker. It's easy.
I'm gonna give you to Mommy.
Reebok, Fila, Nike.
Oh, hon, don't look. I just found your gift.
You're my favorite fish, and I'm gonna wrap you up.
Do you have these cowboy jackets in small?
Michigan for Keith, Notre Dame for Gary.
Wrap the toaster.
You think they got us something?
Get the dog.
Get the boy here, boy.
Joe, what do you see?
Reggie White.
This year, we at Sega Sports really studied the players.
Reggie White.
We learned some interesting things.
Reggie White.
which we use to create a new passing game, Speed Burst, and customized playbooks to give you something that's not just an old coach's game. So, how far did we go to understand the players? Maybe too far. NFL Football 94 starring Joe Montana. Real teams, real players from Sega Sports.
Now,
what do you see?
Sega!
Brad Nessler and Larry Connolly welcome you back to the Billy McCaffrey Show at the Georgia Dome, where the senior from Allentown, Pennsylvania, has put on a second-half display. The best thing to come out of Allentown since Billy Joel's song about the city of, with the same name. What a half. It is 65-57. Georgia Tech knows now that if they don't find some offense, that Vandy is going to pull off an upset.
Vanderbilt's up man-to-man with a little bit of pressure. Look at Lawson out there on top on Forrest.
Forrest over Lawson. Maybe that's the guy they need to get it to.
He's got into seclusion about the last 6 minutes. Haven't heard much from him.
21 for Forrest. Down court pass, McMahon's there. He saved it out to Secker.
Right now, Georgia Tech's thinking about is where's McCaffrey?
And how many guys do we have to put on him?
Boy, they're running that offense well. Watch the screening down inside. Vincent got through, made the switch.
Yes, he did. Secker with a left hand. Georgia Tech's Forrest comes out of the pile with it. 4:20 to play. Vincent. 6-point ball game. There is a plan for Georgia Tech, and it's in the hands of the guy that is the main man in the plan. Vincent's given up 2 3-pointers I think he normally would have taken. Martise Moore will take one. In and out. Morris. That's 2 points for a takedown. Now we got a reversal. And where's Ric Flair when you need it?
Georgia Tech possession.
Georgia Tech ball on the jump. And James Forrest trying to, I think, just gather his emotions more than anything else right now.
Go back and take a look at the battle on the inside. Martise Moore with just a little miss on the outside of the rim. Now watch Forrest go to battle with Lawson. Forrest is trying to get up. Lawson sees the ball. That's a takedown.
That was the two. Now here's the reversal. And that gave the edge back to Forrest. And then cooler heads prevail. 3:53 left in the ball game. It's 65-59. Vincent almost didn't get it in time. Best for three. Wait a minute. Foul. 3 free throws coming up for Travis Best.
You know, you got to give some thought about intelligently defending Travis Best right now. You've got to realize that he's not been shooting the ball well. He's out of position for that shot over there. That's a long shot and a very difficult shot for him. Why go foul him? Just get your hand up and make him make one before he starts to get in his groove. He hasn't shown that he's going to be able to do that right now.
He was falling away in front of his own bench on that one, too. Only 2 for 4 from the line tonight, but an 86% free throw shooter coming in. He's below his season average by 10, but we still have 3:50 to go. If he hits these three, we will again have a 2-point ball game. I'll make it a 3-point ball game. I wasn't a math major. I'm not used to three free throws. Travis has really struggled with this 3-point shot. He led the ACC in 3-point shooting a year ago. He got all three of them. And here's Georgia Tech with some full court pressure and their fans coming to life. Traveling to center.
You know what? If I were Jan Van Bredekoff, I'd call a timeout right now. You got a 3-point lead. You don't want to let this crowd back, put this team back in the game.
And Jan Van Bredekoff just turned around, pointed when Secker came off and said, "You got Best." And he's talking to Billy McCaffrey. The matchup.
Now Lawson and Forrest are going at it inside.
The big tree over the big redhead. Foul underneath on Georgia Tech. Martise Moore. Picks up his second.
Fouls on Drew Barry. His second. Team fifth.
3:38 to go. Vanderbilt leading 65-62.
Let's see if Tech can get another turnover from Vanderbilt. They lost it the last time. I'd give the ball to McCaffrey. He's the most experienced guard out there. Let him bring it up.
And they get it in his hands. And now you just see Georgia Tech knowing that backing up in a hurry. Not only a great shooter, but a great passer as well.
Best now trying to stay with McCaffrey.
McCaffrey has to struggle to get possession. Over Best.
Oh, he's on fire. Oh, I mean, he was all over him. Best was right in his lap.
19-21 for the game. 67-62. Best is maybe thinking about an answer on the other end. A little too much dip, not enough do, but it's still Georgia Tech ball.
Talk about two great guards. Watch the defensive work right here of Travis Best, but the better work of Billy McCaffrey on offense. Look at Best, squared up, ready for the move, the crossover, the move, the hand.
2:53 to go in the ball game. Timeout on the court with Vanderbilt out in front of Georgia Tech by five.
Braun Flex Control, the first electric shaver with a pivoting head. Flex Control automatically adjusts to every contour of your face. Under the chin, under the lip, that tricky spot under your nose. You'll get the closest Braun shave yet. Flex Control from Braun, the last word in shavers.
Recently, at a big building, some of the country's biggest bureaucrats gathered together to resolve a big issue. Will the big chunks on new Pizza Hut chunky-style pizza mean big taste?
I predict it will taste the same.
I predict it will taste better.
I think we should just eat it.
Excellent idea.
Big chunks do mean big taste. Mm-hmm.
New chunky-style pizza from Pizza Hut. An idea so big,
really big,
even a bureaucrat can see it.
Marvel Comics X-Men video packs are at Pizza Hut just for the holidays, so hurry and get your claws on them.
Center. And our promotional partners,
67-62 with 2:53 left. You want to talk about better halves? Billy McCaffrey is making Lyle Lovett and Julia Roberts look sick with this half. This is a better half. 19 in the half and 21 for the game for Billy McCaffrey.
I don't know about you sometimes, I'll tell you.
Is she not his better half?
Absolutely.
That was not a good inbounds play. Georgia Tech in desperate need of some offense. Instead, they get a turnover.
Martise Moore guarding Billy McCaffrey out front. Now the switch by Forrest. Now they got everybody guarding McCaffrey.
Well, three guys have switched off, and he's still working the baseline.
I would not get too cute with this. I'd still keep going to McCaffrey. He's still hot.
The cuteness off the foot. A little too much dribbling for a big guy.
You know what Giant Van Brandekalk just said to Billy McCaffrey? He says, go get the ball. He says, I want you to have the basketball. Of course he does.
2:20. Five-point game. Here comes the Tech.
Travis Best with thumbs down. Let's see the play.
Tech fans desperately trying to get into this to help their team.
High pick and roll.
Best over McCaffrey. He's got it. Two-pointer, Travis Best, 15 for Best.
Interesting change in defense right there, putting more on McCaffrey, a bigger player.
Martise Moore's got to be wondering why he drew the short straw. Milburn underneath, contested, comes back to McMahon. Now McCaffrey's open.
Oh, I thought he was going to make it.
Travis Best fouled him with 1:42, and I think it's a three. No, it's going to be two shots. I thought it was almost going to be three free throws.
I'll tell you what, he was pretty close to that line. I don't know if he wasn't beyond it.
He may have leaned inside it on that final move, trying to draw the foul, which he did. Billy McCaffrey show from Atlanta, Georgia. Man, what a half.
That's 20 of their 30 in the second half.
That's what you call carrying your team.
Big shoulders on that big guy. He's been to a Final Four.
That's right, with Duke. Won a championship, would love to do the same for Vanderbilt. And he's put him in pretty good spot to try to pull an upset here at the Georgia Dome. Five-point game, just over a minute and a half to play. Tech may start having to think about threes. Vincent is in there. He's the guy that can hit him if he gets warm. So can Barry. Moore will take it. Rebound, McMahon. Time running out on Georgia Tech. Both home teams may lose here. Georgia's already lost to Kansas. And a foul on Barry, and he didn't foul the guy that he wanted to, that's for sure.
Fred, I find this almost unbelievable, but Vanderbilt has committed only one team foul seven. In the second half. That means they can give up a bunch of fouls here. Just go out and foul, Tech.
Yep.
They won't send him to the line. I tell you, I don't know if they know that or not. I hope they do for their sake, because the strategy would be just go out and foul. Just eat up the clock.
Billy McCaffrey. How about those numbers? His best game as far as points, 35. He did that in this state over at Athens against the Bulldogs last year. His best half, I think we're seeing right now from Billy McCaffrey. Second one came out on it. That may have opened the door at least a little bit for Georgia Tech to try to find something to squeeze through, but they trail by six. They need him in a hurry. Best foul on the way to the hoop. With 1:04 left, Milburn picks up the foul.
Fouls on Brian.
Don't forget, more college basketball yet to come following our game. We've got 25th-ranked LSU against the 9th-ranked Bruins of UCLA. And hopefully it's going to be as good as what we have had in Atlanta today. 28,169 along with Larry Connolly and yours truly, Brad Nessler at the Georgia. This is about 700 folks off the record they set last year. Record attendance to see a basketball game in this state was set a year ago in this classic. And today they're about 700 behind what they did a year ago.
Brad, I talked earlier about going out and fouling Georgia Tech because Vandy only has two team fouls now. But, you know, you don't do it when you've got a guy driving for the basket like Travis Best, who's capable of making that two-point shot and also a three-point play.
Seven out of nine for Travis Best tonight from the stripe. That's Georgia Tech as a team, I beg your pardon. Best has shot most of them, as a matter of fact, though. Pressure by Georgia Tech in the backcourt. Desperate need of a turnover. But now they've got it in the hands. The Commodores is the guy they want, McCaffrey. They foul Sharon down on the baseline. Marquise Moore.
Well, I'm going to correct myself. I was looking at the scoreboard up there, and it showed one foul on that end. I look at the other end, and it shows five. So they've got five team fouls, Vandy does. So they still have one to give up before they send Georgia Tech to the line for the bonus. You got to utilize that.
Vanderbilt also only nine free throws. Here comes a big one. And he ripped it. Sharon rips it. He's got four all this half. And it is a five-point game. Bobby Crimmins would like to keep it on that 5 points, not 6 points. 5 points can be two possessions. Six actually can be two, but then you know you're putting up threes. Got them both. Big free throw by the sophomore. Dan Van Bredekoff's biggest win as a Commodore coach, probably that two overtime job over Wake Forest last week, but he's on the verge of one even bigger. 6 point game.
Vandy's gone to his own.
Vincent, three. No. Georgia Tech will have it.
And a tight ball.
Shot clock. That is really immaterial at this point. 47.6 seconds left in the game. They need a three pointer. And then they need either a steal or a foul to try to get the ball back somehow.
Georgia Tech. Sharon back in for Vanderbilt.
This has been a good game.
Also, remember now, the clock stops on made field goals in the last minute, so they don't have to call timeouts to stop the clock.
Best three. Got it! 72-69. There's one of the threes. Timeout. 41 seconds, so don't go away, and we won't go away. 41 1.2 seconds left, and Travis Bescher picked a nice time to find his first three-pointer of the evening.
Just as I said, you don't have to call a timeout. Bobby Cremins decided he wanted to do it because he wants to set his defense up. I think that's a pretty good idea because Vanderbilt's been able to handle their pressure pretty easily coming up the floor. They may want to change their strategy in setting up this press. Let's go back and take a look at Travis' best first three-point field goal of this basketball game. You'll see a good screen right here. Now watch the screen right here by Newbill. See, McCaffrey can't get around it, and Best is right there to nail it.
Remember when the second half started and Larry and I said, you know, the big guys have really done a job, and Travis Best and Billy McCaffrey, yes, have struggled to the tune of 2 points for McCaffrey, 4 points for Best. You want to know their totals now? McCaffrey 24, Best with 20. 41.2 seconds left. Georgia Tech is out of timeouts. Vandy's got team fouls to give. Vandy has the possession arrow, the ball, and a three-point lead.
See, now, if what happens in this, and it's very important in a Vanderbilt huddle right now, if there was a turnover or they were to get the ball coming the other way, you got to foul them immediately because that gives you time to set your defense up when they take the ball out of bounds.
On the court for Vanderbilt, McMahon, Lawson, Sharon, McCaffrey, and Milburn, who will inbound. For Georgia Tech, Barry, Moore, Vincent, Best, and James Ford. Full court pressure from Georgia Tech. Oh, and Vincent almost came up with a steal. That was close. And McCaffrey having some words with Milburn, like, what kind of pass was that? So Brian will try it again from a different spot.
Watch the pressure. Lawson's going to come and screen Vincent to try to free McCaffrey. Then he'll roll.
This is a tougher spot to throw in from, isn't it, Larry?
Real tough. Lawson's got it. You know, a good idea. Throw it to the big guy. When you're getting trouble, just lob it to the big guy.
Lawson is a 61% free throw shooter coming in. He is 3 of 5 tonight from the stripe. So he's right about on his average this evening. Newbill will check back in for Georgia Tech, try to get some height in there for rebounding if indeed Lawson may miss a free throw.
Chris Lawson.
39.5 seconds left. 72-69 Vanderbilt.
What do we have? OT last year or close to it?
We had Georgia Tech winning at the buzzer. And Lawson missed it. Georgia Tech with a chance. They're down three. And McMahon looked like Deion Sanders in the middle of the floor, and Georgia Tech just literally threw away a chance to tie this game.
Now you've got the guy shooting free throws. You want to shoot free throws for Vanderbilt, and that's Billy McCaffrey. Look at this. Barry tries to make a no-look pass to the corner, and McMahon was right in his way. You're the man, McMahon.
You're absolutely right. A no-look pass when he should have looked. McCaffrey at the line. Hasn't missed tonight from the stripe, and he hasn't missed much of anything in the second half. Oh, but he missed one there. We talked about Billy McCaffrey and Travis Best, and how about those numbers? They've come through, and it was almost all of it in the second half. Big free throw right here. And he missed it again. Tech with another chance. Under 20 seconds. They need a three to tie it. Best off balance. He didn't get it. But off Milburn.
They have no more timeouts, so they've got to go with it right now.
Last year, James Forrest hit one against Louisville to win it for Georgia Tech. He's done that three times in his Georgia Tech career. Barry's got to hurry. Got it to Vincent. He backpedals. And now we're tied. 72 apiece. McCaffrey weaves down court. Milburn, McMahon, short. Newbill. And we're going to overtime. Do you believe it?
grates cheese.
While some watchmakers brag about their new inventions,
it is a stopwatch and mousetrap.
Loris makes practical watches, like the Loris Vector series. Rugged precision timepieces, equipped with their own direction finders, so you'll always know where you're headed. So forget
it. New Press Spray 9000. Quartz accuracy never tasted this good.
Find your way with a Vector from Loris.
What's up, Helen? Guess I've had this with Stanley about 6 years now. Boys, been through it. Been dropped, run over, beat up. You name it, it's been through it. There's not another thermos anywhere that can take it like this one. See what I mean?
The Aladdin Stanley All-Steel Thermos, guaranteed for life.
Brad Nessler and Larry Connolly at the Georgia Dome for the second year in a row for this classic. And again, we have a classic. Georgia Tech and Vandy tied at 72 as we go to OT. The reason we go to OT, Fred Vincent, first bench points of the second half for the Yellow Jackets from three-point land. Got it.
And Brad, what made that play successful was the fact that he stepped back. He was actually inside the line. He looked down, saw it, moved back behind the arc, and got that three-point play. Vanderbilt had a chance to sock this one away, but the front end of a miss by Chris Lawson on a one-and-one, and two missed free throws by Billy McCaffrey in the second half enabled Tech to tie this game up.
We're at the Georgia Dome, and Vandy with the timeouts remaining. They still have team fouls to give. Possession arrow is theirs, but a full 5 minutes. We got a brand-new game from Atlanta.
Tech continues to entertain us
every year,
right here.
They have never lost in this classic. And they don't look like they feel like making tonight the first. Travis Best coolly running the point guard position now as everybody's settled in a little bit, knowing that we've got a ways to go. 10 on the shot clock.
Now they got to do something. Barry's got to go.
Barry, three-pointer, short. Rebound. Sucker. Played 40 seconds of overtime. Secker pulls up for three. Almost got the roll. Hall got the rebound. Nice pass. As they move it around well.
Vandy passed up a couple of pretty good shots right there. Secker had a little ice in his veins that time,
sure
did he? Right
did.
Down the floor and launched one.
This guy has been on fire the second half of regulation. McCaffrey over Barry. That's an air ball. And Barry, happy with his defense, he should be.
Now you're starting to hear that Tech crowd.
They have been quiet until the last minute of regulation play. Vincent is a guy that wants the ball, you can see that, but Tech will work for whatever kind of shot they can get, not necessarily threes. Newville. Are you kidding me?
An unlikely hero.
That's for sure. 4 points. Ivano Newville.
Well, that was a nice turn, wasn't it? He just packed Lawson right into the middle and got one.
Larry and I say that because we've seen enough Tech games to know that Ivano is not the biggest offensive threat in the ACC.
That's an understatement.
Mahan open for three. Forrest pulled off the rebound. Forrest has gone to work on the boards now and has 13 for the game. Best for three. Got his own rebound.
Bobby
Kremen says, let's get some motion.
Yeah, let's run some clock.
We're down to 2:35 already. Half the overtime is over. Georgia Tech, a two-point lead here in the extra stanza.
Secker must be aware of those screens. Now they go to Forrest.
Forrest up high, got the roll. That's his first basket in a long time. He has 23 points. Georgia Tech has a four-point lead. That is their biggest of the ball game. Turnover. Barry and Best. the first time a smile on the face of a Georgia Tech player.
Tech starting to make the run now. These two free throws could give them a six-point lead, maybe an insurmountable lead.
Funny how shooters gain and lose touches. McCaffrey was so hot for 18 minutes of that second half, and then all of a sudden it just dissipated. Shot an air ball already in the second half, a turnover at midcourt. Travis Best, 21 points and 8 assists. 17 of his points have come in the second half. Billy McCaffrey wishing he could have some free throws from regulation back.
Drew Barry and Billy McCaffrey having a casual conversation right on the Travis Pass.
Timeout. 2:02 left. Let's just let you listen to the crowd at the Georgia Dome. Vanderbilt has not scored since 1:04 remained in regulation. They have gone 3 minutes of overtime without points, and Georgia Tech has a six-point lead. How did they do it?
They had to work at it like this. Down on the inside, you'll see right here the great move by Newbill over Lawson, and that really got it started. That particular shot, and then the dish down inside to Forrest. He turns the one quick dribble, the quick jumper. That's two big field goals, and that's the reason right now that Georgia Tech has been able to put that lead up where it is.
Well, the Georgia Dome with Buzz as our backdrop looked like a giant tomb for the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. It looked like Vandy had this thing sewed up in an upset, and somehow Tech came back. They got 2 3-pointers in the winning moments. As Larry talked about Billy McCaffrey missing those free throws, I know Billy's going to be dying if they lose this game about those free throws.
Well, everything just seemed to fall apart for them in that last minute because Lawson missed the front end of the 1-1. McCaffrey misses two. Then Billy McCaffrey gets a shot out 18 feet out that he would have made 10 minutes earlier, and it's an air ball. Turnover at midcourt, and everything now going Georgia Tech's way.
Georgia Tech is the home team for this event. Even though Georgia was here as well, it was considered Georgia Tech's home game. And we have been treated. Sixth-ranked Kansas survived a Georgia scare in the second half to win, and now Georgia Tech has come from nowhere in what looked like a sure loss to take a six-point lead. Oh, Sharon with a three. He's got two of them this half, 8 points for the game.
Well, what a terrific game he's played off the bench.
Now full-court pressure. Dangerous inbound pass. Newbill got it in the hands of Barry with 1.5 to go. Barry got run over, no foul call. Ball comes out to Best. Barry's going to be at the chiropractor after that one. 78-75, and Lawson comes out and fouls Newbill, and that is not a bad idea.
Smart. Very, very smart. I think much like Georgia Tech decided to foul Chris Lawson earlier, they now reverse that role and put Newbill at the line.
Ivano Newbill, 6'10 senior, 44% free throw shooter. That's his career numbers. I kidded him at the banquet we were at last night. When I introduced him, I said, Ivano's working on those free throws. And he came up to me afterwards with a big smile and said, hey, what can I say? You're right. Oh, boy. I won't hear the end of this if he hits them both.
And you shouldn't.
He's got a hook shot and a free throw in the last couple of minutes. And if he hits this one, Georgia Tech will again be up by 5. Second one comes off. 79-75. Vandy needs 2 possessions, but plenty of time left. McCaffrey will pull up to take a long 3. Lawson saves it. McCaffrey, wise move to try to go for 2, but he didn't get it. But he got his own board. 3-pointer. Finally, Georgia Tech a rebound, and it's Newbill. Ronnie McMahon backing up. You could hear Ivano Newbill say, get off me. And a few elbows started to make their way around Ronnie McMahon's head, and he did indeed back up. Billy McCaffrey took that last 3-pointer, and tonight Vandy continuing to struggle from outside the arc, 4-for-22. Georgia Tech's missed only one free throw in this half, and that was on Ivano Newbill, the last trip down court. But he has had a big couple of minutes here in overtime. Senior out of Macon, Georgia.
I tell you what, that looks as good as any free throw I've seen come off of that line.
Ivano Newville.
So, you know, sometimes, Brad, you get a basketball player like Ivano Newville, who's had very limited playing time here at Georgia Tech, and one game could really spur him on to have a good season. He's a senior, and they really need this from him.
Ivano Newville, every third Saturday of every month since the movie Batman comes out, watches it. Every third Saturday, every month. If Georgia Tech wins this game, he can get a date with Catwoman. It's 80 to 75.
We should be so lucky.
We got a great waitress, though.
Lost it, hook.
Won't go. Barry somehow got a rebound underneath.